say faithful.
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 Faithful is our God.
Faithful is our God.
I'm reaping the harvest.
I'm reaping the harvest God promised me.
Take back what the
we'll be right back. Good morning, St. John. My name is Wesley Shaw, and these are announcements for Sunday, September 15th, 2024. Here at St. John, our mission is the Great Commission, Matthew 28:19-20. Evangelize the lost, equip disciples, extend compassion. Men's Bible study, men studying the Word of God together. Tomorrow evening, September 16th, at 7:30 p.m., our topic will be Serve Readily. The Purple Brunch, Unmasking Teen Violence, Sunday, October 6th at 1:30 p.m. Candid conversation on teen dating, violence, awareness, and how can we help? At Venue 817, 817 St. Andrews Road here in Columbia. Tickets are $25, brunch is included, vendor spots are available. For more information, please visit www.shedidthatevents.com. Tickets on sale for the 9th Annual Purple Gala, Unmasking the Abuse, Domestic Violence Awareness, on Saturday, October the 5th at 7 p.m. at Venue 817. 817 St. Andrews Road. Tickets are $55 for individuals and $555 per table. Tickets can be purchased online at shedidthatevents.com. Formal attire and mask are required. Save the date, Columbia Links Day of Health Resources and Information for Seniors in the Midlands. On October 26, 2024, here at St. John from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Congratulations, Donald Giss and the Giss Law Firm, as one of the winners for South Carolina Excellence in Law. You are cordially invited for the street unveiling ceremony for James and Barbara McLawhorn Boulevard on September the 20th at 3 p.m. 7420 Wilson Boulevard, Langley Management Building, here in Columbia. Reception immediately following the ceremony at Concord Baptist Church, 7831 Wilson Boulevard. We need your voice. Help shape the future of our church. We need your feedback to better understand how we can enhance our ministries and create more engaging experiences for our youth and young adults. Your insights will help us create a vibrant and supportive environment where everyone can grow in Christ and feel truly connected. Scan the QR code to access digitally. Paper copies are also available. Responses are anonymous. Deadline to submit feedback is Sunday, September the 22nd. Fall Revival, 7 p.m. nightly, October 8th through 10th, here at St. John. On Tuesday, October the 8th, will be Pastor Ivory Thigpen II from the Rehoboth Baptist Church. On Wednesday, October the 9th, Pastor Yancey Martin from Union Baptist Church. On Thursday, October the 10th, Pastor Julian Thompson from the Gethsemane Baptist Church. Please join us on Sunday, October the 13th, for the St. John Baptist Church Domestic Violence Awareness Ministry. We'll honor Ms. Jada Graham as a rising advocate and Mrs. Sylvia Davis as a survivor and an advocate. Asia Wilson, Las Vegas Aces star. Asia broke the WNBA season scoring record, surpassed the previous mark of 939 points set by Jewel Lowell in 2023. She achieved this milestone on September the 11th against the Indiana Fever. Congratulations, Asia. The 17th annual Israel Brooks Memorial Golf Tournament will be held on Monday, October the 14th. Registration at 8 a.m. at the Windermere Golf Course. Tee time at 9 a.m. South Carolina 2024 election calendar. October the 4th is the deadline to register to vote in person for general election. October the 6th is the deadline to register to vote online or by fax or email for the general election. October the 7th is the deadline to register to vote by mail for the general election. ID requirements for registering to vote. If registering to vote by mail or in person, provide a copy of one of the following items: any current valid photo ID, or a utility bill, bank statement, paycheck, or government document showing your name and address in your county. Submit your application to the Richland County Voter Registration Office, 2020 Hampton Street, Columbia, South Carolina, 29204. South Carolina African American History Calendar, honoree for the month of September, Mr. MacArthur Goodwin, arts educator. Thank you for the church family of the St. John Baptist Church. I want to thank you all for your monetary gift that you sent to me on my 4-score plus birthday recently. In God we trust forever. Love, Mrs. Claritha Laurie. Thank you to the St. John Baptist Church and Pastor Jamie Graham. Thank you for having such a giving spirit. You are truly a blessing. From Hazine White. Thank you so much. Praying the Lord blesses your giving heart in abundant measure. This is from John White. Happy birthday to our 4-score members for the month of September. Mary Hartz, Francis Hughes, Helen Solomon, Nathaniel Samuel Sr., David Hughes Jr., Elizabeth Rogers, Paul Richardson, Mae Evans, Leon Corley, Carolyn Horn. Best wishes to all those who are celebrating a birthday this month. Weekly Bible verse. Peace begins with me. I have told you these things so that you and me may have peace. In this world, you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world. John 16:33. Remember, St. John, to visit our website at www.stjohnbaptistchurch1900 or our Facebook page for additional announcements. Thank you and have a blessed day.
Thank you, Brother Wesley Shaw, for those announcements. And good morning, St. John. Good morning. This is the day that the Lord have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I will lift up my eyes to the hills, which cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord, who made the heavens and the earth. And I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet have been standing within your gate, O Jerusalem. We just thank you, Lord, for allowing us to see another day on this Sunday in September. We thank you, Lord, for the food on our table. We thank you, Lord, for the clothes on our back. We thank you, Lord, for the roof over our head. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be here this morning. There was someone that wanted to be here this morning but couldn't be here for some reason or another. But we are here. We thank you, Lord. We thank the Lord for the members. We thank the Lord for the workers. We thank the Lord for the ushers, the trustees, the deacons, the ministers, and all those that work to uplift the kingdom of God.
And we most of all thank you for our pastor who will bring the word of God today. We thank you, Lord, for being with us once again on this beautiful day. Amen.
Glory to God. Let us bow our heads. Father, it's once again that we come to your presence. We just want to say thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, for waking us up this morning. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for putting food on our tables. We just want to say thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, for opening our eyes that we can see. Thank you, Lord, for giving us a voice that we can talk. Ears that we can hear. Just want to say thank you, Jesus. We thank you for your word, God. We thank you for Psalms 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High should abide under the shadow of the Almighty. We thank you, God, because we here at St. John are abiding under your shadow, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We thank you for this mighty people. Lord, we thank you for our pastor in a mighty way. We thank you for equipping him, for bringing forth the word. And God, we pray today that we be doers of the word and not just hearers only. That when we leave this place, God, we leave here different, a different mindset, a different thought, a different way of acting, Father, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we ask that your will be done in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, amen. Amen.
Good morning, St. John. Our opening hymn this morning is What a Fellowship, What a Joy Divine. We are leaning on the everlasting arms. Hallelujah. We'd invite you to join and sing with us this morning. So clap those hands, hallelujah. Sing, what a fellowship. What a joy divine. Leaning on. Oh!
Hallelujah. How many are leaning on the everlasting arms? Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We all know that giving is a part of worship, and of course there are several ways to give. They'll show that on the screen, but we're going to have our ushers to come forth as the choir sings this next selection. And give as given unto the Lord. He says, if you give, he said, give and give, be given unto you good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men put back into your bosom. Amen. So let us give as given unto the Lord. May God bless you in heaven, continue to smile upon you.
Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord, let it rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Let the glory of the Lord, let it rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord, let it rise among us. Let the praises the dance of the Lord, let it rise. Let the dance.
gratitude unto God for all that he's done. So we just want to let the Lord know this morning that we are grateful. Grateful. Flowing from our heart are the issues of our heart. His gratefulness.
Grateful for the many grateful folks in the house? How many grateful folks in the house? Hallelujah. Are you grateful that he woke you up this morning? Started you on another day's journey. Clothed you in your right mind. Heart beating right on time. Are you grateful that he saved your soul and he made you whole? Are you grateful that he's keeping you even in the midst of trouble? Grateful, grateful, grateful. Glory from our hearts. Oh, we're grateful this morning. Amen, because he's so good to us. Better to us than we've been to ourselves. Brought us from a mighty long way. Keeps on blessing us over and over and over again. Amen. We give thanks and praises to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ because I'm saved and on the Lord's side. And thank God for his grace, his mercy, and his power. Thank him because he is good. Thank him for his son, Jesus, and for the Holy Spirit, our comforter, our guide. And we praise God for each and every one of you. Let's praise God for our choirs, musicians, blessing us. Amen. And thank you for being a participator and not a spectator. Amen. Because he is so wonderful to all of us. Amen. We certainly give thanks and praises to every honor to all of our deacons, trustees, deaconesses, First Lady, Sister Graham, ministers, wives, husbands, to all of our ushers, the choirs, the musicians, the media ministry, those on social media, our honored guests, visiting friends. We greet you at this hour in the name of Jesus. And yes, there is a word from the Lord. We ask that you would turn with us to 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 7 and 8. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 7 and 8. We're happy to have each and every one of you in the house. And it reads, "For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Therefore, do not be ashamed of the testimony." Somebody said, "Don't be ashamed."
Don't be ashamed.
"Of the testimony of our Lord, nor of his prisoner, but share with me in the sufferings for the gospel according to the power of God." I want to use for a theme or a thought, I want to ask that you turn to your neighbor and say, "Neighbor, man up and stand up for Jesus." Amen. Man up and stand up for Jesus. Don't be afraid to testify. Amen. I know you've heard that phrase, "man up." Man up is used to tell someone to deal with something, such as an obligation or a challenge. Sometimes the wife may say to the man, "Man up." Amen. Or sometimes a brother may say to another brother, "Man up."
Yes, sir.
To your responsibility. Man up to your obligation. Man up means to man up is to accept a challenge in a strong and a brave and a manly way.
All right.
And here Paul is writing to the spiritual timid son, Timothy, to encourage him to be bold in the faith, to be strong in the grace of Jesus Christ, to man up and testify of the goodness of God. He's telling Timothy to man up and stand up for Jesus. And so it is for the Christian man and woman, Christian boy and girl, for you, child of God. Man up means don't be afraid, don't cower down, toughen up. It means to endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. And just want to ask you, are you manning up? Are you representing Jesus in your home? Are you representing Jesus on your job? Are you representing Jesus as a good husband or as a good wife? Are you representing Jesus everywhere you go, on the college campus, on the schoolyard? Are you representing Jesus? Are you manning up?
Yes, sir.
This is not the time for you to be afraid to tell about the Almighty. Not the time for you to be timid about your testimony. Somebody needs to know how good and gracious our God is. In fact, we have some help. Somebody say, we have help. Yes, you should be as bold as a lion. Yeah. Why? Because the Bible says, but you shall receive power. Yeah. Dunamis power. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost power. Explosive power. Anointing power. When the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, in Judea, Samaria, and the uttermost parts of the world. Somebody say, you got power to man up. Yes, you have the power to stand up for Jesus. Don't ever think that you can do this by yourself. No, no. You've got power in God. Don't ever think you can do this by yourself. You need a pastor. You need a church family. You need a mentor. You need a spiritual leader who will lead you and encourage you, instruct you, and pray for you along the way. Don't let anybody fool you into thinking that you don't need the pastor or the church. You need a pastor. You need a covering over your life so that he can pray over you and strengthen you on the journey, so that when you can't handle something, he can pray over you. Somebody ought to say yes. You ought to be able to go to that person, that pastor, that leader, so that he can tell you the truth, so he can pray for you and with you. Young Timothy had Paul, and Paul had Barnabas, and Elisha had Elijah, and Joshua had Moses. Yes, even pastors need a pastor. Even pastors need a mentor. Even pastors need a covering on this journey. Timothy was a young pastor himself. Timothy was an ordained pastor. Hallelujah. But he got timid. He got afraid. He got fearful on the journey. He got ashamed. He was ashamed to testify about the goodness of God. Now, there are a number of things that could have caused him to become timid. But the good news is he had a pastor. He had a father in the ministry. He had a God-fearing man in the ministry who cared about him, who covered him, who instructed him, and prayed for him. How do you know that young Tim was timid? Because in verse 5, there Paul says, Timothy, I'm writing to you to remind you that you once had unwavering faith. You were not wishy-washy. You were not weak in faith. You had unfeigned faith. You had firm faith. You had a strong faith. Hallelujah. In fact, I know how you got saved. I know who your mama is. I know who your grandmother is. They were the ones who witnessed to you. They were the ones who prayed for you. They were the ones who had strong faith. And so that's how you got that strong faith. But somebody discouraged you. Something distracted you. The devil tricked you and trapped you and handcuffed your praise. The devil has hindered your testimony. And now you have become fearful and timid and afraid. You're not the Timothy I know. And sometimes we ought to take an evaluation of ourselves before the pandemic and now post-pandemic. We ought to take an evaluation of ourselves, and you ought to say like Paul, you're not the Timothy I know. You're not the Timothy. You're not the Timothy I know who was strong in faith. The Timothy I know was a follower, fellow worker in Romans chapter 16, 21. Timothy I know served with me as a son to a father in Philippians 2:22. Timothy I know served with me in Corinthians 4:17. The Timothy I know made me gladly declare to the Philippians that I have no one else like him. I could have leave him in Ephesus knowing that what he did a great work, that the work would be done because he was that kind of man. Knowing that he would not be ashamed to preach Jesus Christ and him crucified. But something happened that caused you to be fearful and timid and afraid. Have you ever been there? Have you ever been distracted? Have you ever been discouraged along the way where you needed somebody to put you in check? Have you ever slacked off on the journey? Have you ever stopped coming to church? Have you ever slacked off on giving your tithes and your offering? Have you ever stopped coming to Bible study and prayer meeting? Have you ever stopped testifying of the goodness of God? And you needed some accountability. You need somebody to rein you in. You needed somebody to remind you of your conversion, your transformation. Somebody to walk with you and tell you, that's not the Timothy I know. This is what Paul is doing to Timothy. Thank God for the Pauls in our lives. Who don't mince words, who don't sugarcoat, who don't beat around the bush, who cuts to the chase and tells you what thus saith the Lord, tells you what the Lord, what you need to know from God. Timothy, what made you timid and afraid? Is it the trauma of the pandemic? Is it the ever-changing climate of violence and bloodshed? Why are you not testifying of the hope that lies in you, of the salvation of Jesus Christ in you? What is it? Just know that your testimony is needed more now than ever. And just know that according to the scriptures, you ought not be afraid to testify and share your faith. Why? Because you stand on the shoulders of people who were strong in faith. Timothy, you stand on the shoulders of your grandmother Lois. You stand on the shoulders of your mother Eunice. Put a name there, saints. Put a name there. You stand on the shoulders of Elizabeth Smith. You stand on the shoulders of Milton Kempson. You stand on the shoulders of Nathaniel Wilson. You stand on the shoulder of Clara Davenport. You stand on the shoulders of Roscoe Wilson. Put a name there. You know your mother and father was faithful. You ought to put a name there. You stand on the shoulders of Fairie Mae Graham. You stand on the shoulders of Corinthia Deuce. Put a name there. But it doesn't stop there. You stand on the shoulders of what the Hebrews called the elders, who obtained a good report by their faith. By faith, Abel offered up a more sacrifice, more excellent sacrifice than Cain. By faith, Enoch was walked with God and was translated that he did not see death. By faith, Noah, being warned of God, built an ark for the saving of his house. By faith, Abraham sojourned to a land of promise. By faith, Sarah had a son in her old age. By faith, Jacob wrestled with the angel all night, saying, I'm not going to let you go until you bless me. By faith, Moses, when he was come of age, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer the affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of a seed for a season, of sin for a season. By faith, Joshua fought the battle of Jericho and the walls came tumbling down. By faith, Deborah, the prophetess, led Israel in the battle against the enemy. By faith, Esther risked her life saying to the people, "Perish, if I perish, let me perish. I'm going to see the king." By faith, the three Hebrew boys walked through the fiery furnace. By faith, Daniel survived the lion's den. By faith, Nehemiah built the walls of Jerusalem. By faith, Hezekiah prayed despite the fact that he was sick unto death. And God took out his adding machine, added 15 more years to his life. Somebody say, it's all about faith. And the list goes on and on. Paul said to Timothy, you started out with strong faith. Okay. And you stand on the shoulder of people who have strong faith. Uh-huh. Thus, you need to renew your commitment to faith. Yeah. Then Paul says to Timothy, whatever it is that made you afraid, just know that's not of God. Fear is of the devil.
That's right.
It's not of God.
Yes.
Bible says fear torments, fear intimidates, fear paralyzes, fear cripples, and that's not of God. Fear torments, but perfect love casts out fear. Who is love? God is love. Fear is of the devil, but God can cast out fear. And so whatever made you fearful is not of God. It could be crime or corruption, but that's not of God. It could be suicide or murder, but that's not of God. It could be guns and gangs, but that's not of God. It could be chaos and confusion, but that's not of God. It could be trials and tribulation, but that's not of God. It could be bad news and temptation on every hand, but that's not of God. Paul said in 2 Timothy 1 and 7, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. And when you have these three elements, somebody say three elements, you can testify, you can man up. Look at it there in the text. Number one, you can testify, you can man up. Because God has given you power. Power. You see, the word power is what the Greeks describe as dunamis. Comes from that word dynamite. God has given you what? Explosive power. Enabling power, miraculous power to help you do what you normally and naturally cannot do on your own. In other words, God has given you, yes, I can, power.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
When the devil say you cannot witness, yes, I can. When the devil say you cannot preach, when the devil say you cannot preach, when the devil say you cannot teach, when the devil say you cannot live for Christ, when the devil say you cannot testify, God says with the help of God on the inside of you, you ought to say, yes, I can witness. Yes, I can teach. Yes, I can live. Yes, I can witness.
Yes, I can.
Saying like Paul, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Somebody say, yes, I can. Second reason you can man up and testify of the Lord is because God has given you love. Love. Love covers a multitude of sin. God has given you love. God does not torment us. He loves us. And because he loves us, we have power to love one another. Glory be to God. Ain't no sense in us as Christians going around hating one another.
Okay.
Somebody say that's not Bible.
That's not Bible.
That's not Bible.
No, not
a new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. And the world shall know that you are my disciple because you love one another. Somebody say love. Aren't you glad that God loves you? That God has given you love. Hallelujah. Bible says that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Bible says for God commended his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, while we were yet a mess, while we were yet bad in his sight, guess what? In due time, Christ died for us. And when nothing else could help, love lifted me. I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peace for sure, very deeply stained within. I was sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea, how many of you know that he can reach way down? But the master of the sea, hallelujah, heard my defainting cry, and from the waters he lifted me.
Yes,
Now saved am I when nothing else could help. Somebody ought to say love. 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 Lifted me. God. God did not give us the spirit of fear, but he gave us the power of love. And that's enough to tell others about Jesus. Can I get a witness? Can I give you one more point? Can I give you one more point and I'll let you go? And that is then, finally, you can testify of the Lord because God has given you a sound mind. Glory be to God. The word sound comes from the Greek word sophronismos. Sophronismos, which means discipline. It means self-control. Oh my God, we Christians ought to have some self-control. It means a sound mind. Sound also means healthy and strong and sturdy and unwavering. The word self-control is one of those fruit of the Spirit called temperance. So what Paul is saying to Timothy, pastors and preachers and teachers and lay members, that if you want to lead others to Christ, then you can't be scared. You can't be ashamed. No, no, no. You can't be fearful. You can't be timid. You can't be afraid. It also means you can't be wavering. You can't be wishy-washy. You can't be hypocritical. You can't be in Christ today and outside of him tomorrow. You can't be straddling the fence. You can't, no, you must be sound in mind. You must be disciplined. You must have self-control. You must be strong and sturdy and solid and stable. I mean, you got to be that as a husband.
Right.
You got to be that as a wife.
Uh-huh.
You got to be that as a student. You have to be that as a coworker. You have to be that as a boss. You have to be that as an employee. You got to be strong. And how do you become stable and sturdy and strong in the Lord? Through the power of the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
Somebody say Holy Ghost. Haven't you noticed Peter's life before he encountered the Holy Ghost? He was shaky and wishy and washy. He was in and out. He was unstable in all his ways. One time he said, Lord, I'll stand with you. If everybody else runs away, I'm going to be right there. The next thing you know, he cussing and swearing. He never knew Jesus. But oh, when the Holy Ghost got hold of Peter on the day of Pentecost, the power fell. When the Holy Ghost came, Peter was able to man up and stand up for Jesus. Somebody ought to say yes. And he preached with power. He preached with authority. He preached under the anointing. He preached with conviction. And 3,000 souls believed, repented, and were added to the church that day. We have inside power with God. We have power to walk right. We have power to talk right. We have power to live right. We have power to preach right. We have power to stand firm, stand sound, stand in self-control.
We got the power.
Somebody say, we got the power.
We got the power.
Then we can man up and stand up. Then we can stand up and testify saying, for God I'll live. And for God I'll die.
Yes.
So if the Lord's been good to you, you ought to testify. If he made a way for you, you ought to testify. Bible said the redeemed of the Lord ought to say so. If the Lord saved your soul, say so. If he made you whole, say so. If he plucked your feet out the miry clay, say so. If he gave you grace and glory, say so. If he gave you a job, the office, and the title, say so. If he brought you through the college, say so. If you've been delivered by the Lord, say so. If you've been redeemed, you are too.
Say so.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Is there anybody who's not ashamed of to testify? Not ashamed to own Jesus. Not ashamed to man up and stand up for Jesus. The blind man said, I was blind. Now I see. The lame man said, he told me to rise, take up my bed and walk. And look at me, I'm walking. The dumb man said he gave me my speech. The deaf man said he gave unstopped my deaf ears. The demon-possessed man said he clothed me in my right mind. The woman with an issue of blood said, I pressed my weight through the crowd, saying if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I'll be made whole. And guess what? When I touched him, my life was never the same. I don't need to ask if you can testify. No, because if you're saved, if you are sanctified, if you're filled with the Holy Ghost, you have a testimony. You just need to man up and stand up for Jesus. That leads me to say today that the Lord done saved us, every one of us, from a different position. Some of us were liars, but he saved us. Some were backbiters, but he saved us. Some were hypocrites, but he saved us. Some were adulterers, but he saved us. Some were fornicators, but he saved us. Some were whoremongers, but he saved us. Some were alcoholics, but he saved us. Some were drug addicts, but he saved us. Some were drug dealers, but he saved us. Some were gangbangers, but he saved us. Some were gamblers, but he saved us. Say yeah, somebody. I'm glad he gave me a story to tell. I'm glad he gave me a testimony. Say yeah, somebody. One Thursday night, down in Calvary, I was blind, but now I see. I was lame, but now I can walk. I was dumb, but now I can talk. Hallelujah. I was wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in sin, but Jesus came along, picked me up, turned me around, plant my feet on solid ground. Say yes. I'm glad I got a story to tell. He put clapping in my hands, running in my feet, spark in my eye, joy in my soul, salvation in my heart, praise in my mouth, and a smile on my face. And now I can say, I'll man up and I'm going to stand up for Jesus. Say yes. I don't know about you, but I'm going to tell it. I'm going to swell it. I'm going to yell it. Say yes. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. If there anybody up in here got a praise in your heart, got a praise in your mouth, this is my story. This is my song. Praising, praising my Savior all day long. Say yes. He walks with me. He talks with me. He tells me I am his own. So I got to stand up. I got to man up and tell about the goodness of the Lord. Yes, he'll save you. He'll set you free. He'll deliver you. He'll heal you. You just got to trust him. Trust him. There may be someone today, as we stand to our feet, don't let this moment pass you by. The word, Jesus, God, is calling you out today. Calling you out to accept this obligation of accepting him as Lord and Savior. He's calling you out to accept this challenge, to receive him as your Lord and Savior, to walk with him, to stand with him, to live for him. As the choir sings the invitational hymn, the door of the church is open. There may be somebody out of the ark of safety, somebody who want to join the St. John Baptist Church. You can come under your Christian experience. letter of recommendation as a candidate prepared for baptism. Will you come? Will you give your heart, your life, your soul, your mind to the Lord? Will there be one today? Don't let this moment pass you by. While the Spirit of God is speaking to your heart, step out. If you step out, one of St. John will step out with you. Will you come today? He loves you. He cares for you. He wants to save you. He wants to set you free. He says, behold, I'm standing at your heart's door. I'm knocking. If any man will hear my voice, any woman, boy, girl will hear my voice, open the door. I'll come in, have supped with him. He with me, I with thee. Will you come? This is your opportunity to give your life to Jesus, to be a part of the family of God, a part of the kingdom of God, a part of the body of Christ. Will you come? Don't let this moment pass you by. The Lord loves you. He cares for you. Perhaps you want to be restored. Come under restoration. God wants to bring you back home. Will there be one today? Hallelujah. Praise Him. Oh, yes. This is my soul. Will there be one today? Perhaps there's one who desires prayer. You want to stand in the gap for somebody else. It's your opportunity to come that we might pray the prayer of faith together. Yes, yes, yes. We're praying for Sister Tammy Brown, who has a broken leg, for her healing and restoration. We're praying for those on our prayer list. We're praying for the bereaved families. We're praying for the St. John family, that we might continue to grow in grace, wisdom, knowledge, understanding, that we might grow together as the body of Christ, as the people of God, that we might man up and stand up for Jesus. Let us pray. Father, we come once again in the mighty name of thy Son, Jesus, thanking you for the many blessings you bestowed upon us, thanking you for life, health, strength, thanking you for allowing us to come to your house, to feel your presence, to worship you in spirit and in truth, to hear your word of challenge, to man up and stand up for Jesus. God, we thank you right now that we know that this is also a house of prayer. And we come praying today on behalf of these your people who stand around this circle, all over this sanctuary, on social media, on our prayer list, and those we cannot call by name. We know, God, that you're a prayer answering God. And so we come in the mighty name of Jesus. Some stand in the need of one thing and some are standing in the need of another. But we know you have 10,000 blessings in your hands just to satisfy us all. So whatever we need, you have it right now. Whatever we need, you can supply right now. So we come in the name of Jesus, asking that you would remember those who are lost, those, dear God, who need you as a Savior. We ask, God, that you would touch their hearts as they heard this word today. And those, dear God, in our homes and on our jobs, we pray that you would save to the utmost. And for those under the sound of my voice who want to be saved and accept you as Lord and Savior, we ask that you would help them to believe in their hearts that God has raised you from the dead and confess with their mouths that Jesus is Lord over their lives. Save to the utmost. Help them to repent of their sins, change their hearts, change their minds, change their direction. That's repentance. And Lord, turn unto you right now. So we ask that you would save our sons and daughters, save our mothers and fathers, save our husbands and wives, save our co-workers and classmates, save to the utmost. Father, we pray for those who are sick and afflicted right now. Those who've had a bad report from the doctor. Those, dear God, whom the doctors claim they have cancer or COVID, claim that they have high heart disease or high blood pressure, claim they have kidney disease or mental illness or mental health issues. We ask in the name of Jesus, let your blood cover from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. We know there's power in your blood. We know there's healing in your blood. Let your blood cover. Cast out the affliction that's plaguing their bodies right now. Jesus, we thank you that you were wounded for their transgressions. You were bruised for their iniquities. The chastisement of their peace was upon you. And by your stripes, they are healed. We feel the virtue flowing from your throne. They are healed even as we speak. Curse the cancer to its root right now. Dry it up in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray right now that you would heal in the name of Jesus. Then, Father, we pray for those who are bereaved, those who are sad, those who are in sorrow, those who are depressed and in the valley of despair. Give them joy that will flow like a river, joy unspeakable and full of glory, knowing that the joy of the Lord is our strength. We pray for families right now, husbands and wives, sons and daughters. Bring that marriage back together. Bring that family back together in the name of Jesus. Destroy that yoke of conflict, the yoke of unforgiveness. Lord, give them love and peace and joy and power to heal and forgive in the name of Jesus. Then, Father, we pray for leaders of our nation, from the president down to the mayor of our city. We pray for this election season that we all go out and vote our conviction and put in the right person, dear God, that will lead this nation to peace, prosperity, hope, and healing in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, that you will look upon each one of us. Give us the power to look beyond each other's faults, see each other's needs, and meet those needs. In Jesus' name we pray. We count it done. We claim the victory. We say amen. Amen. Amen.
This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Oh,
this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Oh, yes.
We praise God for this worship experience. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I want to say a few words by way of announcement. Jada and the Domestic Violence Ministry, we want to ask them to stand. They want to thank you all for your support of Jada and also the Girl Scout. Please stand, the Girl Scout, because this is a Girl Scout also. want to thank you all for your support on her Gold Teen Dating Violence Project on yesterday. Let's give it up for them. It's a marvelous presentation. Thank you so much, Jada, for that presentation, and for the domestic violence sister, LaDonna, for helping her through the project thus far. Amen. Let's give it up for Sister Jackson Bennett. Jackson Bennett. Amen. Want to also just remind you that yours truly will be preaching revival on Monday and Tuesday, September 23rd and 24th at Mount Moriah in Camden, South Carolina. Please, if you can, go along with me. Pray much that God will do a mighty work in that revival. And of course, on that Wednesday night, September 25th, we will be at Gunner's Chapel right down the street at their revival. So pray much for these revivals that God will move in a mighty way. Amen?
Amen.
Sister Dion Fleshman was featured in the Panorama for announcing her candidacy for Richland School District 2 Board of Trustees. Let's give it up for her. I don't see her in the house. But pray much for her as she runs this campaign and as she seeks that seat. And we are claiming it even now. Amen? So please continue to pray and support her in whatever way you can. Congratulations to Kirsten and Marcus Arnett. Marcus and Kirsten Arnett had a beautiful wedding on yesterday. The parents may be here. Is Brother Virgil here? Anybody else here from the family? Let's give it up for them. Amen. Beautiful wedding. Beautiful wedding. You've already heard the congratulations to Asia Wilson for breaking the WNBA single season scoring record. Let's give it up. Amen. Amen. Also, if you would show that slide, where Deacon Duncan's photo is on it. Congratulations to Deacon Duncan. Of course, you know he's over the Office of Resilience of our state. But we want to congratulate him for being the panelist at the Congressional Black Caucus in D.C. on solar justice, bridging the energy divide in the black community. Let's give it up for our Chairman Deacon leading even over our nation. Amen. Want to also say that the deacon and the late Sister Barbara McLaughlin will have a street named in honor and memory of them on this Friday. It's going to be a boulevard named after them. On Wilson Boulevard near Meadow Lake. So if you would come, please join us. The announcements are on the screen. It also is in the on your website. But it's 3:00 on Friday. So let's come out and celebrate this great honor. Amen. If the McLaughlins are here, let's give it up for them. Amen. Also, we want to say mark your calendar for HBCU Sunday. October the 20th, October the 20th, HBCU Sunday. The Family Ministry Unit coordinators and leaders, deacons, have a meeting, a special meeting on tomorrow. So you should have received that link for that meeting for an appeal for you to help with your Family Ministry Unit. We pray and hope that we could have Family Ministry Unit tailgate that Sunday. Tailgate that Sunday. So we want to have a great fellowship and a great showing for our college, our 8 HBCU colleges across the state of South Carolina. Amen? Minister Victor Rogers, let's give it up for him leading us today. Want to ask him to stand. At 3:30 today, at the Orangeburg National Guard Armory, he will be... there will be a retirement ceremony. He's retiring from the Army National Guard after serving our country for 24 years. Let's give it up. Amen. Amen. Now, in addition to our honored guests, I want to say we're glad to see Alfonso Counts III and Jasmine are here with their family. We want to thank God for Reverend Kennedy's daughter who's with him worshiping today. Reverend and Sister Greg and Pamela Daniels and family, they're here today. Reverend Cheatham's wife is worshiping with him today. Brother Nathaniel Samuel's daughter is worshiping with us today. And the Corley's daughter, they're worshiping with us today. And it's also good to see Brother Philip Johnson worshiping with us today, our member. May I miss someone. If I did, please blame it to my head and not my heart. I'm just trying to look out on the horizon. Want to also, Jordan is here today. Amen. Jordan Benjamin. She's Miss Homecoming for Spring Valley. Let's give it up for her sister. Amen. Her grandparents are here. Grandparents, if you would stand. Amen. Congratulations, Jordan. Amen. Among the many other things that she's doing, amen, the great things she's doing along with our many, many students, amen. our Deacon Epps, Boykin Epps Jackson Family Ministry Units, the greeters for this month. Sister Brenda Hollis is going to recognize our honored guest, Sister Diane Marion and Sister Ida Miller. They will be giving out this special gift to those who are our honored guests. Amen. Continue to pray as she comes. Continue to pray for Sister Tammy Brown, who has a broken leg, but we know God is healing her even as we speak. Amen.
Good morning, St. John. We did not receive any visitor cards, but if there is anyone or any visitor that did not fill or did not have the opportunity to fill out a card, please stand at this time. Reverend Graham.
Amen. Thank you so much, Sister Hollins. We praise God that all of us are members of St. John. Amen. Amen. Potential members. Amen. Amen. I mentioned all of the families who are here because we are our family church, and we encourage you to bring your family members. We're here to worship together. Amen. God bless you. All hearts and minds are clear. Let us stand. Reverend Johnson is going to lead us in our offertory prayer, and we'll be ready to go.
Let us pray. Father God, we come thanking you right now for all that you have done, God, all that you're doing, and all that you will continue to do. We thank you, O God, for the financial blessings that you have bestowed upon us. We thank you, O God, that we were able to come into yet another service.
Yes.
And partake in giving, O God. Although we may not have all given all that we could have or wanted to give, but God, we thank you because you provided a way for us to provide for the upbuilding of your kingdom.
Yes, God.
We ask you, O God, right now to press it down, shake it up, and to provide right now for all that it is duty bound to provide for.
Yes.
And we ask you as we move forward to do the things which are assigned to our hand to do, that you, God, continue to get the glory and all of the honor. In Jesus' name, amen,
amen,
amen, and amen.
Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace, shalom, health, healing, wholeness, prosperity, success, long life with satisfaction and salvation until we meet again. And we all say amen,
amen,
amen, amen, and amen. Remember the survey. Remember the survey. We have one more Sunday. Remember the survey. God bless you. Our choir is going to come at this time.
So much for me.